Sir, I want to ask you about presses. You gave some testimony to Deb. Were there any presses at the Walmore Road facility?
Oh, yes, there was all kinds of presses.
And what were the presses used for, sir?
Presses?
Yeah.
The presses, they were to cut disc.
Were these sandpaper discs?
Sandpaper disc, fiber disc.
Do you know the manufacturer of those presses?
Well, the two big presses we had, it was Blitz and Dake.
How do you know those two companies were the manufacturers of the presses you saw at the plant, sir? How do you know it was either a Blitz or a Dake press?
Because they had their name on the frame.
What were the size of these presses, sir? And I'm just looking for general testimony.
Huge. I mean, so maybe one would be able to fit in over here, but 16, 18 feet.
Did you ever have occasion to work on the presses?
Yes.
By working on the presses, do you believe you were exposed to asbestos in any way?
Yes.
Can you explain how, sir?
When you were removing the lining.
Where were the linings? What kind of linings are you talking about, sir?
Horton. Horton lining,
what,
yes.
What were these linings used for?
To stop the press. At a certain point.
So there were brake linings?
Brake lining, yes.
Okay. And let's talk about the presses. Generally speaking, where were these linings utilized on the presses?
Well, if I recall, on one side was the flywheel with the small handbrake, and on the opposite side, on the left-hand side, it was the brake for the whole press. It was riding inside of a drum, okay?
And is this a drum brake system?
That's a brake system.
And using your hands, can you show me the size of the drum approximately?
Well, I think so it was about good, I would say maybe, let's see, my machine was sitting there, about good 16 inch in diameter. Outside.
So the drum is actually circular, right?
Yes.
And can you explain, just generally speaking, for someone, you know, like me who never worked in a plant, how did this brake system work, this drum system? What did the linings actually stop?
It stopped the flywheel from coming down, okay, to engage the clutch.
And these linings that were used on these presses, can you describe for me the shape and size of the linings?
The lining, it was sort of a dark color, grayish, gray, black, okay, that color. And they were half moon. You had to shape it to half moon to conform with the brake.
Okay.
With the shoe itself.
The lining itself, how often on one of these presses would the linings have to be replaced?
Well, it depends how many people were working on the press and how many shifts were working.
Okay. Can you give me a range? How often?
Well, sometimes there was maybe every 3 weeks. Sometimes there was a month. Depend how big of a order they have and how many people were working.
Would you on occasion have to remove the old linings?
Yes, I did.
On occasion would you have to fabricate and install the new linings?
Yes, sir, I did.
So let's talk about the removal. What process or steps did you take in removing a lining?
Well, first, when they mention it in that press is sliding down, I used to go and check the drum, okay? Blow the drum and blow the two halves, okay, inside the drum.
What would you blow it out with?
With an air hose.
After you air hosed, what was the next step in removal?
I removed the drum. And then you remove the shoes with the lining on top of it.
Okay? Now, how would you remove? How were the linings attached to the shoe?
By rivets.
How would you remove those, the riveted linings from the shoe?
Okay, like I said, you flip with the shoe and the lining together upside down. That was in a space where the rivets was, there was a little hump, okay, from pin, from the hammer, you know, you pin your rivets.
Okay.
Okay. So sometimes you take, to make it easy, you take a grinder, a disc grinder, you grind it, okay? Make it easy for yourself. Some days to take a punch and punch it, and days to beat that things until they come out. But I wasn't doing that. I used to take a grinder, disc grinder, grind it and make it even with a shoe.
What tools would you use to cut the lining?
We used to use a dual.
What was the air like when you were using the dual saw on the lining?
Very dusty. Dusty, okay. And black.
And after you did that, you put the rivets or the screws in instead of the clamp. What was the next step, sir?
The next step? Well, I had the two pieces. Then I was going on a bell sander, okay? On a bell sander, and then I made it perfect fit, even with the shoe.
So you would take some of the protruding lining out so you would have a flush, it would be flush?
Yes. So I, for example, that thing was sticking out like this. I used to put it on a bell sander, and if there was that much left over, I used to go in and grind it down. So that was even.
What did the air look like when you'd use the bench grinder on
it? It was dusty, black.
Did you ever see any warning labels at all on the brake linings that you worked with?
No, sir.